Hello everyone, and welcome back to The Legend of Zelda, Breath of the Wild, where I found Nedra, whatever that is. I'm trying to get to it, because I don't know what it is, and it looks interesting, so I want to find out. Unfortunately, it is way up there, it looks like. So I'm not too sure if I'll be able to get over to it in the 2.5 minutes of cold resistance that I still have left. Because once that's gone, that'll pretty much be it. Because all I've got right now is the warm doublet. And this area is real super cold. Whoa. What is this? Oh, that looks gnarly. That is a lot of malice. Like, holy crap. You've done well to find your way to the spring. You have overcome numerous trials and obtained the spirit orbs. The one you see before you is an attendant to the spirit of wisdom. This is Nedra, the blue spirit of Lanayru. Servant of the goddess has looked over the spirits of this land for ages, unknown to the world of man. However, the dreaded malice unleashed by Calamity Ganon has possessed its body and reduced it to its state. You have received the spirit orbs. Free Nedra from this malice. See what your power can achieve. Oh my! Well, I do know how to deal with malice. That is just by shooting it in the head. But Nedra's now moving. Or not the head, but in the eye. But now Nedra is moving, so that's wonderful. That updraft did not get me anywhere. So I need to shoot at the malice again. But that might require me to climb up a bit higher. Depending on how high this updraft is carrying me. Not very far, to be honest. I'm not sure if I can do this, because I've only got a minute of cold resistance here. I might be okay, because it looks like it's a lower amount of cold in this area than it was in that other area. But I won't really know until my cold resistance goes away, and I have no other cold resistance either. So this is kind of gnarly, though. Like, wow. This major creature is gnarly looking. I'm all the way at the top of the mountain now. This is the coldest area that it can possibly get. Nice, nice. Okay, I have enough cold resistance where I'm at. Alright, let's climb a little higher. I've never seen this before, so this is kind of awesome. I'm just climbing up freaking ice right now. Oh, Nedra's running away now. Maybe if I wait, Nedra will come back? Probably not. Probably have to follow it everywhere it goes. Yeah, it's way over there now. Oh, maybe it's coming back. Or not. No, I don't think Nadra's coming back. Well, let's try to follow it the best we can. Don't really get any, like, stamina here, so... But there is an updraft going on here. Oh! It's like Divine Beast of Meadow. Engage. Disengage. Come on. Switch to the... Freaking... Bow. It would not let me switch to the bow at all. And for that, I took damage. And basically died. Flying up. Shoot. Shoot. I can only hit one at a time in each area, it looks like. I say guess so, because it looks like Nydra's probably moving now. Yeah. Now I had to follow Nydra again. It's creating an updraft, I think. My stamina meter is going down real slow here. Now it's not, okay. So that's something to be wary of. Don't want to shoot it while I'm in the air in that case, because I won't regain any of my stamina. Or maybe I will. Come on. Let me shoot at you. Shoot. I missed. Shoot at it. Got it. Got it. Nice. It's Nydra. Ooh, it's real pretty. It's Nydra! No idea what it is. Some kind of great spirit, according to that. I wonder what this does. Thanks to your efforts, Nydra, the spirit of Mount Lanayru, has been freed from the grips of an evil power. But a single ceremony remains. Now, loose your arrows through the body of Nydra to free the spirit of this region. I have to shoot it? Ring of Wisdom. I wonder what this does. It's like I'm getting something. This is the spirit of Nadra's scale. It fell when your arrow struck. It serves as proof of the courage you received from the one who served the spring since ancient times. Come. Offer a scale from the blue spirit Nydra to the Spring of Wisdom. Precious scale fell from the blue spirit Nydra. It contains a bitter cold within. Use it in cooking, but just eating it seems like a waste. Oof, this water is probably freezing cold too. So I'm definitely going to want to use my Cryonis and be very careful. I will get these very close together. Hope that I don't fall off. and completely muck this up. And show them the scale. Blue Spirit Nadra is released. To now offer Nadra's scale to the spring here. And I do that by doing what? I just drop it here on the thing. I don't know, I've never done this before. I didn't even know this was a thing. I guess we just drop it. I'll try praying now that it's there. Oh, maybe I have to drop it in the, like, actual water? This is gonna be a bad idea if this doesn't work. Hey guys. There's a shrine! Wow. Path has shown itself. Now go forth. Well, I guess it wasn't even deep water, so I don't think it actually is going to deal any damage to me. Look in it. Jitan Sami Shrine. Never been here before. Oh my goodness. This is yet again something that we get to explore ourselves. Like I said, this game's all about exploration. You know, there's so much in this game that's just pure exploration. It really is. When night falls, skeletal stall monsters will emerge from the grave. Stay vigilant. Maybe this is one of those shrines that's just instantly beaten. Yes. You who set foot in this shrine, I am Jitan Sami. By entering this place, you have already proven your worth. So this is some of the shrines. Some of the shrines are literally just this. Oh, you got here to the shrine, so that proves that you're worthy. And I don't mind that so much because there's usually a really long trial just to get in here. Look at this weapon though. Oh my god, that looks amazing. And I won't skip over this because these guys say something different. Done well to arrive at the shrine, a hero rises to right the wrongs of Hyrule. In the name of the goddess Hylia, I bestow upon you the spirit orb. Nice. Well, there you go. It's good that I went ahead and used my cold resistance to get here, huh? May the goddess smile upon you. And then he just fades away like all of the other, well, people do. I just fell over. In my chair. How about that? It's almost 3:30 in the morning right now, actually. And it is also super cold in this area, obviously. Means I probably want to leave this place. Yeah, how about that? Spring of Wisdom. Nadra's Snowfield. So yeah, I guess Nadra's gone now. But we do have a picture of Nadra. Fortunately, it's a picture where Nadra is covered in malice. So there's a thing. Great advice taking the form of this giant dragon, making its home in the Lenaver region, said to have served the spring of wisdom since ancient times. An old saying goes, the dragon ascends to the heavens as the sun begins to set. Nobody has seen them, this in the current age. The ice that coats its body makes it dangerous to get near, but Nadra bears no ill will toward people. Huh. How about that? Alright. Well, there's that. There's four special treasures of some kind that that are part of the compendium, but I don't know what they are. Hey, look, the Peak of Awakening. Don't know if that's a Link's Awakening reference, but it sounds like one, so there's that. I guess at this point, what we can do next is head onward. I'm looking at the wrong. No, I'm not. I was looking at the right thing. I need the adventure log. Hylian homeowner, Robbie's research. Let's see. Here we go. Locked mementos. I need to head back to Impa now. Now, our horse is over here. But there is a way to get Twilight over to Kakariko if I just warp there. So I might just go ahead and do that. It would require me to warp down here, but that's alright. I guess we'll just go ahead and warp. I tend to just warp to places, and thus I tend to actually leave my horse all the time. Just kind of leave my horse behind. So, it's unfortunate, but what can you do? But that was cool, though. Like, I've never seen that. I've seen the fire dragon, but I had never seen the ice dragon. So now I'm curious what that is to do with the fire dragon. Like, what it is I can do with that, and if that'll give me, like, a scale or something that I can then turn in to get to another shrine or something. I guess I just have to try. But now that we have the camera, there's actually a lot of side quests we can do here, and that will actually unlock another shrine for us. Hey, look, it's Paya. Master Link, anything the matter? Anything at all? What's that ball? This priceless artifact here? Is that what you want to know about? This is a Sheikah heirloom that we have long protected. The hero, as chosen by the Sheikah heirloom, will be gifted the blessing of antiquity. With these words as our guide, we have watched over this sacred artifact since my grandmother's grandmother's time, and even since her grandmother's grandmother's time before that. I cannot say that I entirely know the meaning of these words, but now that I think about it, the hero was chosen by the Sheikah heirloom. Could it be? Please don't hesitate to let me know if I can ever be of service. This village? We Sheikah have long served the royal family of Hyrule in secret. During the great calamity 100 years ago, the royal family was destroyed, and the members of our tribe scattered. Sadly, there were some who swore allegiance to Ganon at that time. They joined together as the Yiga clan, seeking out all who opposed Ganon, cutting them down one after another. Master Link, now that you are awake, you are surely the most formidable opponent standing against them. No doubt they will come for you, employing whatever underhanded methods they can devise. Oh, but of course, if there's anything I can do to help you, all you have to do is ask. The great fairy Kotera. Only a few remain who know this, but this village was built under her watchful eye. The mysterious power of Kotera is that of sacred protection. I suggest you seek her out. The great fairy resides behind the shrine that overlooks this village. That is where you should seek her. You can put your trust in the great fairy. I can't think of any reason she wouldn't be happy to help you, Master Link. Please don't hesitate to let me know if I be of service. What's your story? You want to know my story? Well, my name is Paya. The reason I was named Paya is because I have a birthmark shaped like a papaya seed. Where is it? Well, it's kind of... Master Link, I advise you to change the subject. I'll add you some today, just not today. So, Paya is adorable. And the nice thing about having the camera now is... you can pull it out and take pictures of people. Ow. That was a bad picture. Hello, Impa. Can I take a picture of you? No, it doesn't register. You aren't anybody important then. Oh, I should, take a picture of my spear. I switch to my self-portrait. Oops. Really, I do know how to do this. I can take a picture of the frost spear. I think I take it from the front. And I'll add that to the compendium. I should go in and clear out my pictures. Every single picture you take adds to this. Even if it's pictures of stuff in the compendium, you can just sit here and delete all these and it won't affect your compendium at all. So it's generally a good idea to go in and clear this out, unless you find something that you want. If you're just taking pictures for the compendium, oh, that looks cool. It's also sad because it's the freaking... I'm sad I didn't get a picture of it while it was the ice dragon. I only got a picture of it while it was the malice. Huh. I heard Pura was giving you the runaround, but you seem just fine. Locked mementos. Complete. Now then, let me see. Aha! Uh-huh. This is without a doubt the camera that Princess Zelda used 100 years ago. It could be that if you visit the locations within those pictures, you will be able to restore some of your lost memories. Come back here once you have tried going to at least one of those locations. There is something I wish to give you. Captured memories. New objective. Alright. So we've lost the Lost Mementos quest. It's finally complete. Now we have captured memories. There are 18 memories to recover. It says there's only 12 if you look at the side quest. But there's actually more because there's other memories throughout the game. However, I do know of one memory that we can easily access. I just have to go here. It's actually up in this area, which I don't actually have a map of. But we'll travel over here. I am hoping that if I load something in the background where I can use a map, that it won't cause any footage corruption. I won't have any way to find out until after I'm done recording this episode, so I highly hope that nothing weird just happened to the footage. Again, I highly hope. I have no way of guaranteeing, unfortunately. So, it doesn't usually cause any issues, but I don't know. This thing has been real finicky as of late, so I'm hoping that it didn't cause any issues. I suppose, I could always end this episode off a little early, just so I can double check and make sure nothing happened to the footage here at the end. Dead. Really? I didn't get any Boko parts, just their clubs. That was nice of you. Here, something for your troubles. Tough pumpkin scoot. Pumpkin stew. We really need to get to safety. Alright. We should count ourselves lucky for that. Well, I gotta admit, being able to freeze enemies with just a stab of the spear is pretty awesome. So there's that. We'd easily get a bunch of wood from here. I do not want to use this against these guys. It'll probably turn them into ice choo-choos. So, you know, don't want to do that. So there is a Sheikah Tower for this area way over there. But I really don't want to go over there because it would not be good. So I kind of have to do all this without a map. And that's going to be a little difficult. I just have to look at where I am on the map in comparison to where I am here. It's kind of straightforward, honestly. So I need to turn off in this direction. I think it's over here by this forest area. There's a path that leads there to where I need to go. There's a lake next to it. Lake Kalamo. And this might actually be Lake Kalamo from what I'm seeing. So I need to go this way a little further. I think that's where I need to be going, is right over there. Get out of it's further up here, one of the two. Because there is a forestly area. Yeah, so this is this, so it's at that section there, yeah. That's where I need to be going to. Again, I don't have the map of this area, so I can't just look it up, unfortunately. Kalamo Garrison Ruins. Let's see if there's anything around here to see. Go fast. Whoa. Okay. It's raining, so I can't actually climb anything. Never mind. I hit that wall and just slid down. I was like, what the heck? But yeah, it's slick. That's why. Because it's currently raining. I didn't even think about it. So, oh well, what can you do? It should be somewhere around here. Again, I don't have the map to this area, so I don't know for certain. But it's like just north of the Omen Owl Shrine. So, it's probably further off in this direction. It is somewhere around here, though. That's about all I know. Yeah, it's on the left side of Lake Kalamo. Somewhere over here. I ran out of stamina. So, there's that. Come on. They're not gonna attack me? I didn't think so. What now, huh? Octorox are scared of me. I'm still sad that they haven't brought back land to Octorox. They still kinda stuck with the Ocarina of Time water only Octoroks, which is unfortunate. But at the same time, it does make sense because you have the Guardians, and they were based off of the idea of the Octoroks originally. The, like, feeling of the giant Octoroks from the original Zelda, so they weren't giant Octoroks, but the one developer was like, yeah, they always felt like they were giant to me, and we kind of took that idea and used it, so I don't think I just missed it, but I might have. This is Lake Kalamo, and it looks like this is the edge of it. And it goes up and around over there. And it's somewhere along the one edge here. It's in the forested area, so I think I did already pass it by. It's hard to find, actually, unless you know exactly what to look for. And even when, like, you find it, you still have to kind of search a little bit for it. Because it's not, like, exact what you where you think it's going to be in accordance with the map. Even when you go straight, even when you have the map and you go straight to the location that's on the map here on the guide. So, if I had a way to get to that Sheikah Tower, and then come back, I would do that, but I don't think I can climb that tower yet, because that one is well protected, like really well protected. It's ridiculous how well protected it is. Pretty sure it's in this area though, with the trees. It's just, it's hard to find, it really is, because it looks, it's like you have to be looking out to Lake Kalamo to actually see what it is, to see what you're looking for. So, well, I think I will go ahead and end off this episode. So I do hope that you have enjoyed. If I don't find what I'm looking for here pretty soon, then I will probably just come back here later once I have the map of this area. Because the last time I had to, last time I looked for this, I had to use the map in order to even get a rough idea of where it was. So without the map, I don't really know that I can find it. So, because it's, it should be right around here, and I'm not seeing it. And I'm not even sure if I'm in the right area, to be honest. It is directly north of Omen Owl. If this is Lake Kalama, then this should be the location right here, but I can't see it on the map, so I can't really find it. So, well, like I said, we'll come back to this. It's not like it's a big deal. That said though, I do hope that you have enjoyed. At this point, we're really ready to do anything at this point. We can do the Divine Beasts. Can try to search for memories. There's a lot of stuff that we can do at this point. And exactly what to do, I haven't decided yet. So but I'll figure something out. That said, I do hope you've enjoyed. And I will see you all in the next episode. So, see you later.